Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Got a slightly different video for you today, so let's just cut to the chase. We're talking about the YouTube nonsense that's been going on recently. Normally, I take exception to making videos about this stuff, because, well, for the most part, I feel like most of the other people get to the points, and also, I don't know if it directly affects me. Even when YouTube implemented its ridiculous new terms of service that outlawed controversial topics, I really didn't feel too worried because I thought there's no way they can actually enforce that. Now there is something that directly affects my livelihood, and whilst before I could have more easily adapted or thrown things under the rug in order to make things work that maybe I didn't want on the channel anyway, now there's real complications. So let's just explain this mess before we go any further. YouTube has recently had an algorithm change on the site. YouTube's algorithm dictates the way in which videos are recommended, discovered, etc. It's basically how YouTubers get their views. This used to be based on relevant search terms more predominantly, as well as the size of your subscriber base, meaning that if you had a Destiny subscriber base and you told everyone in the title of the video that you would be talking about Destiny news, more than likely they would see it. Not only would they look at you in their sub box, but also you would rise to the top of the recommended searches because you were a Destiny channel. Now the algorithm has changed and channels around YouTube have reported 30 to 50% less views than normal on their videos. Look at any of your favorite YouTubers and I guarantee that at minimum a handful of them are starting to experience this. Now the algorithm has changed in such a dramatic way that it's actually really damaging to us. And the way that the algorithm has changed, it doesn't sound bad at first, but now it appears that videos are getting more commonly recommended based on whether or not they have high engagement, aka comments and likes. I see why YouTube is doing this. They're doing it for the same reason that they changed the ad revenue structure on YouTube to favor videos that are longer than 3 minutes as well. YouTube wants to keep people around on the site for longer to be more competitive, and the way of doing that in their minds is to create a more engaged audience on YouTube. Here's the problem with that. The way they did it, once again, is blunt. YouTube has, as they have done in the past, taken a hammer to a problem that should have been solved by a wrench, and in many ways, they've started to screw over YouTube as a platform for creators by doing this. Just like with Google+, and just like with the new copyright system. Let me just expand and explain why. First of all, it's worth noting that the idea might have been to create a more engaged set of audiences that would have stuck around for longer, but the reality of it is that the likes and comments that we see as engagement can actually be just the opposite. Why? Because channels that have lots of likes and engagement on them are just the ones that beg for likes at the beginning of every video or do a giveaway to drive the metric artificially. I don't want to say that necessarily begging for likes at the beginning of a video is a bad thing, but it just means there's a very interesting point that has to be brought up about it, which H3H3 points out excellently in the video they made. People start at the very beginning of the video and ask for a like, and that's a problem because if you're liking the video just at the very start, you have no idea what the content of the video is. It looks as though there's engagement, but the reality of engagement should be that the subscribers are actually grappling with what's in the video and saying, "Hey, I enjoyed this." Being asked to like at the very beginning does the exact opposite. You're told to switch off, follow suit, and simply like according to what you've been told, and comment down below. It's even worse, I feel, when someone's throwing up a giveaway, not necessarily because of the fact that a giveaway is a bad thing. No, I've done many giveaways on my channel in the past, but having to do them repeatedly just means that you end up with a comment section that is filled with meaningless stuff. Comments that are literally just there to satisfy the premise of leave a comment and like this video in order to win at a giveaway. As I said, these channels are admittedly just playing the game, but as I told you, there is no way of guaranteeing that any of this content is good quality stuff. And that's what really concerns me. YouTube is being filtered down. Now, I don't very often tell you guys to like my videos, and when I do so because I want to get an idea of your level of support for something, or because I want to show that I put more effort into this than I did with my normal videos, and I want that to be appreciated. Keep in mind that I write scripts for all of my videos, and I'm not afraid to shy away from controversy when covering Destiny, even though it hurts, and all the while, I do so with no entitled expectation that you'll all like my stuff and comment on the video. You know why? Because I just don't want to bother you all. Because I know that not everybody who watches will want to hit the like button, because that's just how some people are. Some people just want to sit back and listen to Destiny stuff. Some people want to sit back and hear my opinions on things. And I respect that viewer. I respect the people that sit back and don't say anything. Because you know what? Even though the comments section is the vocal part of my audience. That silent majority is also huge, and it's something that remains silent and therefore sort of has to be respected. I feel like it is therefore the more respectable thing. Not to mention that the likes on the videos that I throw out there, they're real, they're not artificial. Nobody is asking you to throw a like out there for the most part, unless there really is something that I feel is worth it. So that's why I don't ask. But my concern isn't just a personal one. Yes, I'm impacted by this. Yes, it's going to be a little bit harder for me to make a living on YouTube with these changes. But realistically speaking, I'm a medium-sized channel, and I can at least adapt and work in a system like this. But I really do fear for smaller channels, which can't generate thousands of likes and thousands of comments on each video. I wonder whether out there right now, there's an aspiring YouTuber whose chances of making it on YouTube were just snuffed out by these changes, because they may make great informational content, but they don't ask for likes. I think about all the content that's been potentially lost to us now because of that fact. And it unsettles me because I think of how I made it big on YouTube, and I remember I was a small channel at one point in my life as well. I did most certainly get there through collaboration and being a part of a community, but ultimately, I understood how I was supposed to get videos up there, and it was a pretty straightforward system. Now, that's what unsettles me. And I'm not going to say that the last system was perfect either, I'm not that naive. I don't think that the platform's prize system of having people just fill their titles and descriptions with jargon and search terms to get to the top of the search engines was necessarily healthy. Hell, I had to play that game, and to an extent I still do, and it still pisses me off a little bit. But what I can tell you is that this was a blunt cudgel to a problem that again required something of a fine-tuning method to it. YouTube has always struggled to be taken seriously as a platform. And you know what? It's a twofold thing. From its internal follower base, this is why, because every single time they try to adjust something, they destroy quite a lot of what's there in the process. It happened with Google+ when they tried to implement that, and then eventually they dropped it because it was such a huge failure. The copyright deadlock system that exists on YouTube, where literally only just now have they started to implement a system where people like trolls can't get behind videos and steal the revenue from honest people trying to make a living. And now with this, where all of a sudden tons of their top content creators have started to lose viewers and subscribers, which I'll talk about in a minute, for seemingly no reason. And they told us nothing about this. As people who have a much larger stake in YouTube because we earn our livings off of it, I would have at least liked a mention, I would have at least liked something to notify us of this incoming change. Yeah, they have the right to change it, but for crying out loud, you shoot yourselves in the foot because we now have less views and you have less money, and as a result, you know, you take the lion's share of what we earn. But what's more, in terms of taking YouTube seriously as a platform, are the people outside that they supposedly wanted to please by making it a more serious platform. This, keep in mind, is part of the reason why they implemented the new automated copyright claim policies. I remember that this was part of their drive to legitimacy. They wanted to say that YouTube should be a place for high-quality content, and that was obviously one of their cover reasons. Although, I'm probably sure that that's just because of the deep pockets of the movie and film industry, but what you gonna do? However, let's take YouTube at their word for a second there, and just say that yes, this is indeed going to be a place where we want high-quality content. You just frankly shot yourselves in the foot. In fact, you didn't just shoot yourselves in the foot, you took a grenade, dropped it at your feet, and shot that. You lost both your feet, and now you have no legs to stand on. You've gone backwards. Lackluster content now has a better chance of bubbling up to the top based on whether or not the guy making it forks out enough money for a bloody Amazon gift card. And that's not right. That is not right at all. So what happens to me now? Well, that's kind of an interesting one, because I have to live with these changes. Changes that will not only hurt me, but also changes that hurt smaller YouTubers. That's you and everybody else who came before you on YouTube, if you are one of those aspiring YouTubers. Sadly, I do have to adapt with this. I certainly won't be leaving. I'm not gonna stop doing YouTube at this exact moment in time. I don't plan on doing that anytime soon either, so you can expect me to stick around. But there's something I all have to ask you all now. And again, I hate doing this, because again, I don't want to bother you with more stuff than is necessary. I want to get the information to you, make sure it's accurate, but I guess now I have no choice. So sadly, I'm gonna have to ask some of you to like the video at the end of each video. I won't do it at the very beginning, because I don't want you guys to be misinformed about what you're liking. I want you guys to know whether you've watched the video and enjoyed it, or found yourself informed. So yeah, at the end of every video, sadly now, I'm gonna have to ask you to like it, where before I didn't want to bother you. On top of that, and this is the bit that I really hate, I have to talk very briefly about this unsubscribe glitch that has been screwing over myself and a whole bunch of other YouTubers. For those of you who don't know, whenever you upload a video on YouTube now, certain channels are being hit by a glitch, which means that they randomly have a proportion of their subscriber base unsubscribe. It's ridiculous to see this, and at first I didn't feel like it had happened, but I got tweets from various different followers, one of whom is a mod on my YouTube gaming streams, that said they had been unsubbed. And they're a mod! I've had people who even have email notifications on for my channel, which I really appreciate because I've never asked for that, and they've been unsubscribed from my channel. What the hell? Seriously? That's going on now? This is a thing? I'll admit it's been a thing for quite some time, but it's 2016, YouTube's been around for more than a decade. Fix this, guys, come on. It's not that hard, I'm sure. You've been in this business longer than anyone else. How can you not have fixed this by now? It's laughable. But anyway, that's the change I need to make. I now need to go ahead and ask you guys to like at the end of every single video instead of just the ones that I think are significantly better and are worth your time. So yeah, that's kind of where I'm at right now, and that frustrates the hell out of me. And there's one last thing I do need to ask you to do, and this is what's even more frustrating. If you guys are people on this channel that have gained any kind of value out of it whatsoever, if you feel like you've even been slightly informed, if you feel like there was a point when the lore video has entertained you, anything of that matter, then I implore you, if you are my regular subscribers, help keep me afloat. I want you guys to go ahead and hit that notification bubble. If you look next to the icon where my channel icon is in the description down below, there'll be a little bell. Hit that and turn on email notifications. That helps me stay afloat. It means you get notified of my content when it's out there. I hate doing this. I really don't like doing this. This is one of those moments where I sit there and I think YouTube really has taken a step backwards. Because literally look at what I'm doing right now. I'm a channel that, you know, I pride myself on trying to bring you guys good quality content where the information is accurate. And yeah, I slip up. I admit those failures openly. But when I'm driving to try and make higher quality content, YouTube is actively stabbing me in the leg when I'm trying to start running. I can't keep going like this with high quality content now without acting like I'm a channel that needs the likes to hide some kind of low quality content. And that's what's killing me. Content should be able to speak for itself, but on a platform like YouTube, that's not possible anymore. If I had my way, I'd say that it should be impossible for anybody to say like the video within this, but of course, that's curtailing freedom of speech. And you know what? That's more important. But regardless, I think I hate this most because now every YouTuber is forced to beg for their living. We're forced to beg you to like our videos. We're forced to beg you to comment on it, to drive that engagement so that we can make a living. That's not how it should be. I'm a firm believer in the idea that good quality content should speak for itself. So what's this video gonna do? What's this ultimately accomplishing? I don't expect a revolution from this. I don't expect any kind of saving grace to come from this video. I just hope that you guys are a little better informed about the situation that many YouTubers are in. If you have somebody whose content you love, whether it's myself or someone else, keep them in mind. Make sure that you're subscribed. Throw on notifications, because ultimately, YouTube just became a much harder to play game, so to speak. Anyway, sorry if this is such a downbeat video for some of you guys. I understand that a lot of you don't like it when I go negative, but in this instance, you know, this affects my living and the living of most of my friends. So yeah, I just want to make sure I get this out there to you lot. Anyway, for those of you expecting more content, I'll have some Mass Effect and Destiny news as well. And on top of that, there should be some exciting lore content from both games coming soon. Mass Effect should be tomorrow. There's exclusive gameplay for the Game Awards going on, hosted by Jeff Keighley. So hopefully I'll have some cool video stuff for you guys there if you're into Mass Effect. And if you're into Destiny, of course, PSX at Anaheim is coming up soon on the 3rd to 4th of December, so we should have some very exciting SRL content launching soon. You know, there's going to be good stuff coming up, I guarantee you that. But in the meantime, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I guess I best start doing this now. Feel free to leave a like and a comment on this video if you enjoyed it or found it informative. My name is Bife. Prodasia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.